In this lesson, we will discuss the general characteristics of laminar flows and turbulent flows in pipes. One of the most important parameters in studying flows in pipes is the Reynolds number, which is denoted by the abbreviation RE. For pipe flow, the Reynolds number is defined as the fluid density rho times the average fluid speed V average times the pipe diameter D divided by the fluid viscosity mu. The Reynolds number is a dimensionless quantity that allows you to make predictions about the characteristics of a flow. Imagine that we have three pipes filled with a fluid flowing left to right. The flow speed, pipe diameter, and fluid may be different in the three pipes. We insert a small tube into the pipes that will inject green dye into each of the flows. In the bottom pipe, dye appears to travel in a straight line and mixes with the surrounding fluid very slowly. In the middle pipe, the dye sometimes travels in a straight line and other times moves in an unpredictable manner. In the top pipe, the dye always moves in an unpredictable manner and mixes with the surrounding fluid rapidly. The bottom pipe shows typical behavior of flows where the Reynolds number is less than 2300. We call these type of flows laminar, and they are predictable and mix slowly. The top pipe shows typical behavior of flows where the Reynolds number is greater than 4000. We call these type of flows turbulent, and they are unpredictable and mix rapidly. The middle pipe shows typical behavior of flows where the Reynolds number is between 2300 and 4000. We call these type of flows transitional, and they have characteristics of both laminar and turbulent flows. It should be noted that 2300 and 4000 are only approximate cutoff values for laminar, transitional, and turbulent behavior in pipes. For example, if great care is taken to not disturb the flow, it is possible to delay the onset of turbulence to Reynolds numbers that are much greater than 4000. However, under typical everyday conditions, the values of 2300 and 4000 are reasonable cutoff values. Notice that, thus far, we have not specified the flow speed, pipe diameter, or type of fluid in the pipe. The Reynolds number cutoff values for laminar, transitional, and turbulent flows are valid for any combination of flow speed, pipe diameter, density, and viscosity. We can visualize the different flow regimes another way by examining the axial velocity component, Vx, at a single location in the pipe as a function of time. For laminar flows, the axial velocity component is constant in time. For turbulent flows, the axial velocity component varies unpredictably about a mean value, Vx bar. The axial velocity is expressed as the sum of Vx bar, which does not change in time, plus Vx prime, which is the deviation of the speed from the mean value. It is Vx prime which varies unpredictably in time. For transitional flows, the axial velocity component will appear constant at certain times and will vary unpredictably at other times.